Hello everybody, I'm going to do a review on this 3CFM two-stage vacuum pump I picked up from Harbor Freight. This is item number 60805 for reference. These retail for $199. It was on sale for $149. I applied a 20% off coupon, so I picked this up for $119.99 out the door. Of course, it came with the pump, came with the manual, a little bit of information in there, and it did come with some oil. I poured all this oil in it, not quite to the max line, but within range. We'll get to that momentarily. But this is a 3CFM pump, and they also sell a 2.5CFM pump, which I have used before. A friend of mine has one, and it works fine. But the reason I picked this one up with the 3CFM over the 2.5 is this is a two-stage, so it should draw a little bit better and maybe a little bit faster. Secondly, the reason I purchased it was some crackhead or meth head decided to help themselves to the copper underneath our rental property, went underneath the house and stripped it all out from the system, blew the gas out and everything. So I'm going over there to fix it and recharge the system, so I needed to use a pump and I didn't want to keep borrowing my neighbors and my friends. So I picked this one up. It is what it is. It has a port on the top. It has two ports on it. You can use the R12 or R22 gauge connections there for the hose, or the 134A right here on the side. This one actually did not have an O-ring in it. It does now. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be in there, but it certainly didn't have one. And I'm not going to be using this port, so I needed to make sure it was sealed off proper and I wasn't leaking vacuum. This one does have an O-ring in it, so pick the port that you'd like to use, hook it up to your gauge set, and there you go. This red knob right here is where you fill it with oil. It does not have oil in it when it comes. You do have to fill it, so make sure you do it first or you'll burn your pump out. So I just dumped everything in there and that's what I got. It does have an air vent right here, like most vacuum pumps. The on and off switch is right here on the back. Hopefully you can see that. Not a bad looking machine, pretty decent looking. Steel, a little bit of plastic on it. Everything else looks to be aluminum. There is a drain plug underneath the front. I'll show it when I can get a shot of the side. I've got oil in it, so I don't want to turn it upside down. I'm going to go ahead and let you hear it, but then I'm going to pick it up off the bench because it's going to rotate quite a bit. So I'll just try to, I'll just leave that on there for now, just so you can hear it pulling a vacuum. So here we go. Hopefully you hear it vibrating off my bench. I don't know if you heard that, but it did pull some vacuum off of it. You know, these will, like all vacuum pumps, you'll need to check your oil level from time to time. And that's kind of where the contaminants, based on my knowledge, are going to end up anyway. So make sure you keep good oil in it. I don't believe Harbor Freight sells vacuum pump oil. I'm not sure. They might. You might have to look elsewhere. But any supply house that sells refrigeration-based equipment and stuff like that, just go ahead and tell you need some vacuum pump oil, and they'll sell you whatever you need. Let me go ahead and just hook a gauge up to it here. This is just an old set of Robinair gauges. Speaking of Robinair, go out and price their pumps. You know, this is not going to be getting hardcore use from me, so I'm certainly not going to spend what it takes to get a professional or top-notch quality of a pump. So I'll go ahead and get this on here. It's only going to take a brief second to suck it down because there's really no volume in here. And these are reading in inches of mercury here on my gauge. And this is supposed to pull down to like 22.5 microns. You do your own math converting that out. So anyway, let's turn it on and see what it does here. And of course that pegged the needle right off. So I'll go ahead and let the vacuum out of it. I will be showing a clip of it pulling down once I get my copper replaced. You know, this would be good for automotive application. I'm sure a lot of people would be using them for that over what I'm using it for. But if it's going to work for me, pulling down a split system with a 7/8 OD pipe and then 3/8 on the high side on probably about a, I don't know, a 20 foot run or so, it should work just fine in an automotive system. So in a nutshell, that's it. It seems like it's going to do the job for me. Like I said, maintain your oil levels, and it should work for quite some time. Here's a quick shot of the sight glass where you check your oil level. It's hard to tell here, but it is not at the maximum. It's actually one line down in terms of quantity that came with it. No big deal. It's well within the range of operation here between minimum and maximum. So when it gets dirty and nasty looking after time, just simply change it out and put in some fresh. This is the drain plug right here to drain the oil when and if you need to change it. Just simply take that out, drain it, put it back in, and fill it back up with oil. It also does have an externally fan-cooled motor on it underneath this rear shroud. Hopefully you can see the cooling fan in there. It seems to move quite a bit of air across these fins right here just from feeling it running. So it should keep everything quite cool, and it should work just fine. All right, well, here I am. I got the new copper installed, getting ready to flick it on. It's kind of loud, kind of a busy street. Let's see what it's doing here. Looks like it's already almost down to 20 inches. Well, like I said, this is a split system, so it's actually got a decent volume of air in it, almost down to 25 inches. So I'll let it pull down and see how far it goes. All right, well, it's drawn it down just to about 30 inches of mercury, so it pulled it down and, oh, within just a minute. So I'll let it run to evacuate the system and then charge it up. Well, all right, well, my final thoughts on this vacuum pump is it worked, and it worked great. I had no problem evacuating the system. It did it. It pulled it down into the vacuum very quickly, for that matter. But, you know, and I left it sit there and run for a good hour since my system was broken open because they stole the copper. So I did pull it for an hour. I had no problems with it. It maintained its vacuum throughout that. It seems to start a little noisy, and I think they mentioned it in the manual. And after a couple of minutes, as it draws down, it'll quieten up. And it did that very thing. But all in all, it works great. I would recommend it. You know, I think it would even work better or equally as well for like AC systems in a car. If you guys are doing or looking for something like that, you might consider one of these, or at least try one out. And if it doesn't work out for you for some reason or last as long as you'd like, you can always bump up to a higher priced pump. But for me, it worked great. Thanks for watching and good luck.